there is a number of fantastic online code generators that can help you visually create complex code ready to use in your projects. Those are really helpful and can really speed up your workflow. Here, I want to outline the best CSS code generators that you'll find handy when you're creating user interfaces. First up, we have a shadow palette generator by Joshua Comeau. And Joshua is a fantastic developer, and you should absolutely check all of his work, from tutorials to courses to generators like this one. And if you're asking yourself, what's the big deal with creating shadows? Well, it's not a big deal to create box shadow in CSS. It's one line of code. But if you want to create a beautiful, realistic shadow, then that is quite a bit more complex. And this generator will help you do exactly that. You can play around with those options to create exactly the shadow that you want. And as you can see here in the preview, those shadows are absolutely stunningly beautiful. And the code required to create something like that is not simple at all, as you can see by this CSS right here. If you want your CSS shadows to stand out, then use Shadow Palette Generator by Joshua Comeau. Next up, we have Fancy Border Radius Generator by Marco and Niels Binder from 9Elements Company. This is a really interesting one because border radius, again, as is the case with box shadows, seems to be quite a simple property, but if you want to create a little bit more fancy border radius, if you want to create border radius that is not proportional, then you will have to use a syntax that looks something like this, and this online generator will help you create exactly that. So this online fancy border radius generator can help you create organically looking shapes using only CSS border radius property. Next up, we have GetWaves, and this is a generator that will help you create stunning waves. Those can work really well as section breaks or as breaks between header and content or content and footer and so on and so on. There is a number of options you can change here to get exactly the type of the wave that you want. Using this can really make your design stand out by breaking out of the usual boxy look that we usually get on the web. The generated code is actually an SVG that you can include directly into your website. You can either download it or you can just copy the SVG code. And speaking of organic section breaks, a while ago I created a guide on using DynamoWaves library that helps you do something similar to this generator right here, but a little bit more dynamically. So if you still haven't, check that video. Link is going to be on the screen and in the description. And next up, we have Fuel. A Fuel is not actually a single generator that does one thing, but it's a collection of a lot of different generators that you can use and explore. I've used a lot of those in my projects. I really like them, and I definitely think that you should check them out. For example, one that I really like is this coil spiral waves generator that will help you create this wonderfully looking wave that you can use in your designs. I've actually used an SVG image generated by this very generator on the landing page for my course, Mastering LinkedIn, and let me just really quickly show you how it looks. So here's the landing page, and you can see that generated image right here in the background. It helps me create a little bit more interesting break between those two sections, dark and light. And speaking of Mastering Prettier and Stylint, this is my course on, well, Prettier and Stylint. It's currently in production. I've already completed and released a number of modules, and the next one is coming hopefully in the next week or two. And as long as we're already here, let me give you an additional discount. Use the coupon code CSSGenerators and you'll get additional 40% discount on already discounted pre-launch price. And of course, by enrolling in this course, you're not only helping yourself become a better developer, but you're also helping support CSS Weekly and this particular channel. Thank you so much. In any case, Fuel is a number of different CSS generators or SVG generators that will help you spruce up your designs, so make sure to check them out. There's a ton of interesting generators here that you can use directly in your designs as backgrounds, as section breaks, or whatever you want. And while we're speaking about the collection of CSS generators, another one that I want to show you is actually CSS Generators Project by Emmanuel Fifth. And this is, again, a set of CSS generators from custom borders, section dividers, and so on. Those generators are really handy, really practical, and you should probably check them out. And of course, check out the other work by Temani Afif, because Temani does fantastic work ranging from CSS challenges to CSS tips, and so on and so on. Next up, we have Scrollbar App. And this is, as the name says, an online generator that can help you create code for a custom scrollbar. As a rule of thumb, Don't change scroll bars on the websites, but if you want to or if you have to, this tool right here will help you create exactly what you want, because as you probably know, if you ever try to create a custom scroll bar, this is quite a bit complicated. There's a number of properties that you need to use, and those are only available with the WebKit prefix. So using a generator like this one can really help you create custom scroll bar if you ever want to. The next generator that I want to show you is a glass morphism CSS generator, and this does exactly what it says. It creates this glass morphism effect where the backdrop is coming through but a little bit blurry. And talking about glass morphism effect, a while ago I created a video on how to create a glass morphism effect in CSS if you want to create it by hand, so check that video, link should be on the screen right now. And this generator is of course a very handy way to create a glass morphism effect visually by just tweaking those values, tweaking those sliders, and of course you can then just copy this code and use it directly in your projects. Next up, we have Modern Fluid Typography Editor by Adrian Petze. This is a generator that will help you create modern typography. And fluid typography is an approach to specify typography dynamically, so you don't specify fixed font sizes for different breakpoints, but you specify font size based on the viewport units and then based on the actual screen size from the user's browser. This will dynamically change. This is usually done with the clamp function, but there are some challenges with creating that, and that's exactly what this generator will help you do. You can specify exactly the values that you want for your fluid typography. You can play around with those values here, from minimum size to maximum size to fluid size, and once you're happy with the results, you can just copy the code and use it directly in your projects for your font sizes. Next up, we have Cubic Bezier by Lea Vero, and I'm quite sure that Lea doesn't need introduction. Follow her everywhere where you can find her, and this generator will help you create custom easing functions. You can use ease in or ease out, but those are quite a bit boring and a little bit dull. Here, you can visually create exactly the animation curve that you want, and of course, you can preview it right here. Once you're happy with the result, you can just copy the code from here and use it straight up in your animations to make them a little bit more dynamic, a little bit more interesting, a little bit more attractive. The next generator that I want to show you is again created by Joshua Comeau, and it's actually a gradient generator. And the difference between this generator and the standard generators for gradients, it actually allows you to create a more naturally looking gradient. Of course, you can play around with those values to get exactly the result that you want, and once you're happy with the result, you can copy the code from here. And to understand exactly why this needs a generator, this is an example of generated code. If you want to have a natural looking gradient, you can't just go from one color to the next one. You actually have to create all of this to get this nice looking gradient effect. Another fantastic project by Joshua Comeau. And speaking of beautiful gradients, another project, another generator that I want to show you is Mesher. And this generator allows you to create mesh gradients. And those are gradients that look something like this, where the colors are flowing from one to another and create this really beautiful, really interesting effect. You can just use spacebar to randomly generate different gradients, or you can play around with those options right here and create exactly the background that you want yourself. So these are online CSS generators that I wanted to show you in this video, and have I missed any of the generators that you're using? Please share them in the comments, I'll be happy to check them out and maybe even include them in one of the next videos about online CSS generators. Thank you so much for your attention, my name is Zoran Nyambor, I will see and hear you in the next online CSS generator, or rather, in the next video.